Y'all sipping that lean, right? Keep on sipping it. Listen, have a good time. Enjoy. Enjoy. I'm clean with this. But check it out. Listen. Third life. They say it takes 21 times to make a habit. We're going to see how this go. I'm on here for more than dancing, though, I promise. But my hat is backwards. I done drank most of this caffeinated beverage, so y'all finna deal with it. We got stuff to get to, though. I ain't gonna hold you. I got a little reveal. I got my art supplies back from my grandparents' house the other day. And I don't know what's in here. I just know I used it more than 10 years ago, and we finna see what's to it. My hands look enormous. I'm gonna work out after this too. I should finish this. The drill shit don't work the same way. We gonna get to it. That's how you know this is over. We gonna get to it. I used to take this on the train. I used to take this on the F train. I used to take this on the J train. What other train I took? The E train. I remember what happened with this too. I was on the E train and it was crowded and the doors opened and people were getting off. Someone kicked it. Either someone kicked it or like I put it down and it, or like it knocked against the pole. Something happened with the structure of the train. Cracked my whole shit. But that's how you know it's real. What do we got? What we got? I made this. Ink dropper, you know, a little funnel. Still useful. Blades. I don't have to get new X-Acto blades for a minute. X-Acto knife. Micron. But what else we got? Terpenoid. This is for oil paint. I had no business using this in my grandparents' house. They did not have the kind of environment that's set up to use this the right way. It has to be hyper, like, super ventilated and big open space. And I definitely didn't have that freshman year of college, but I still used it. I made it work. All this stuff must be from freshman year. This is one of my projects from college. It's a Kanye West inspired hair care thing. I don't know what I was thinking. I signed it K-Yeezy. Wow, this is interesting. This is interesting. Ruler. but like a flexy one. Y'all should see what inside this stuff. Y'all should see inside. You know what I mean? Like, we gonna go deeper. I don't know what else is in here. This is another reason I wanted to show y'all what's in here. Because even just like looking through it quickly, I saw a bunch of brushes I hadn't used yet. Like this one. And funny enough, I want to say I got this from my mom, but look closely. Like it still has makeup on it. I'm saying that to say this is a makeup brush. And I actually really like using makeup brushes because it's extra soft. And I don't know, something about it just seems a little more authentic, especially when painting black women. I don't know. So is this one. This isn't a makeup brush, but it's also unused. I cannot wait to use this on an abstract. This is gonna go crazy. My playlists are fire. I don't know what to tell you. Here we go. The treasure trove. I haven't seen this in like 10 years. Another makeup brush. Paint. Another blade. This one's a little thicker though. Feel me? What else? I got a lot of makeup brushes. This shit. That's good. I got a lot of X-Acto blades. So far, this is the makeup brush count. Can't wait to use these. What else? Hopefully this is still have something in it. Yes. Blue ink. This is gonna be interesting. I haven't used this in a while. What else? Some loose paint. I'm so glad I checked their house. White paint. Artists, you already know, always need white paint at all times. It's never a moment where you don't need it. I'm really glad I found these. What else? Brown paint. Gum Arabic. Increases transparency, brilliance, and gloss. It's for watercolor. Haven't used this since college. I have the perfect piece to use this for. I just have to finish it first. So I'm gonna set this to the side because out of all this stuff, I'm probably gonna use this most immediately. Gum Arabic. Winston Newton. Windsor Newton. It's empty, but it would have been a good time. Green ink. What else? Very excited, just found these. You know, painting with long brushes can be really, really effective. And because I work with makeup brushes a lot, I don't have as many long brushes as I should. So I'm really happy to have come across these just now. I know exactly how to apply them. Like exactly how to apply them.
Want me to rock, you got a book in there. I thought this bitch, I took the pussy from
day. What else? More oil paint. A lot of this, I'm realizing this from my freshman year of college. And I was more focused on oil painting at that time. Now I do more acrylic and watercolor. But I was super more, I was way more focused on oils in 2007. So it's interesting to see all these oils now. Another amazing brush. Palette. All the years of built up paint, palette. Got it on the outside too. This is love. Finally, black ink. I'm gonna find something to use this for. That's the reveal, man. Everything. Oh, last but not least. Hmm. 2007. I used to use this to clean my brushes. It's just interesting looking at it right now. It's taking me back to that time in the studios at the School of Visual Arts in 2007. Working so hard, making so many sacrifices. It's just like, wow. It brought me right back to that moment. Anyway, this concludes my little live reveal of the stuff that I grabbed from my grandparents' house. I can't wait to start continue to use these artist tools. And I guess, you know, this video exists now for a lot of reasons, but among all of those reasons, one of the most important being so that there's some example of a black man holding art with two hands and sharing it. And making himself available as an example of excellence in the arts. But let me know what you think. Peace.